You're watching Reality Check. It's been 4 days now since the terrible violence in Lakhimpur in Uttar Pradesh, where 8 have been killed. 4 days in which the police have not made a single arrest. This despite an FIR which names Ashish Mishra, the son of Ajay Mishra, the local member of parliament who's also the minister of state for home of this country, of running the farmers over. The FIR charges the son with murder, amongst other charges. Despite a viral video showing a Mahindra Thar Jeep running over a group of farmers, a Jeep which Minister Mishra accepts is his. The absence of arrests has given the accused and his family more space to go public with their claims of innocence. In fact, the minister, Mr. Mishra, was in Delhi today, controversially meeting Home Minister Amit Shah, where Mr. Mishra reportedly presented his defense. Sources in the government claim the government appears to have accepted Mr. Mishra's argument that while the killer Jeep does belong to him, he and his son were not present at the scene of violence, ruling out, they say, any question of Mr. Mishra having to resign from the government. All of this, the delays in arrests or even questioning influential accused persons, but yet the swift arrests or confinement of opposition leaders attempting to visit the families of the victims has raised serious doubts over the impartiality of the UP police. I was able to put some questions on this to UP's additional DG, Law and Order Prashant Kumar, who, remember, had actually gone to Lakhimpur to mediate some kind of quote-unquote settlement with the farmers, where I began by asking him, why is the police still not able to arrest Mr. Mishra's son, even though now it's been 4 days?
ये पहले तो आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद और मैं स्पष्ट करना चाहूंगा कि बहुत सारे ऐसे प्रश्न थे जो कि आज के पहले भी थे, लेकिन उन चीजों को पूरे ओवरऑल पर्सपेक्टिव में चीजों को देखना मेरे हिसाब से उचित होगा। अच्छा? जिस तरह की दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण घटना, अनफॉर्चुनेट इंसिडेंट उस दिन 3rd को हुआ था
जी,
उसके बाद से कानून व्यवस्था बनाए रखना एक बहुत बड़ी चुनौती थी राज्य सरकार के लिए और यूपी पुलिस के लिए, और हम लोग उसमें पूरी तरीके से सफल रहे और जो भी पक्ष था उनके, उन्होंने जो भी एफआईआर कराई, पहले तो इस बात पे भी बहुत, जो प्रश्न आज आप पूछ रहे हैं उस समय यह प्रश्न था कि एफआईआर होगी कि नहीं होगी
जी।
तो मैं सबसे पहले आपको स्पष्ट कर दूं कि जैसे ही ये घटना घटी, शीर्ष स्तर से, उत्तर प्रदेश शासन के शीर्ष स्तर से ट्वीट किया गया कि इसमें किसी भी दोषी को बख्शा नहीं जाएगा।
नहीं,
और उसके बाद से जो किसान जो जिनकी डेथ हुई थी वहां लोग एजिटेट कर रहे थे
जी।
तो एक कमिटी यहां से भेजी गई, हाई पावर्ड कमिटी, जिन्होंने उनसे बात की और जो किसानों ने और जिस पक्ष ने जो लिख के दिया कॉमा फुल स्टॉप एवरीथिंग, सब कुछ एफआईआर में दर्ज किया गया।
वो आपकी बात सही हो सकती है कि एफआईआर दर्ज किया गया, जो एक्चुअली वो तो नेचुरल प्रोसेस ऑफ लॉ है, लेकिन मेरा सवाल ये है कि अब एफआईआर दर्ज होके 3 या 4 दिन बीत चुके हैं, कोई भी लीगल एक्सपर्ट सुप्रीम कोर्ट से लेकर बाकी जो सारे लीगल एक्सपर्ट्स हैं वो कहते हैं कि मर्डर केस में अरेस्ट शुड बी इमीडिएट, और ये क्लियर कट केस ऑफ मर्डर है। वायरल वीडियो भी आ गया जिसमें हम देख रहे हैं कि एक जीप आ रही है, उसे लोग कुचले जा रहे हैं, तो इसीलिए सवाल उठ रहा है कि अभी तक
मैं कह रहा हूँ कि आप पूरी बात जस्ट हमें आप 2 मिनट का समय दे दें
जी,
और जैसे ही लोग डेड बॉडी को रख के एजिटेट कर रहे थे तो उनसे वार्ता की गई और जो वार्ता हुई उसके बाद से डेड बॉडी का पंचायतनामा किया गया, पोस्टमार्टम कराया गया और 3 डेड बॉडी कल डिस्पोज की गई फैमिली की संतुष्टि के बाद। एक डेड बॉडी के संबंध में परिवार को डाउट था तो एक विशेष टीम लखनऊ से भेजी गई जो कि स्पेशलिस्ट डॉक्टर्स की थी, जिन्होंने दोबारा पोस्टमार्टम किया
जी।
और पोस्टमार्टम के बाद ये पूरी ट्रांसपेरेंसी बनाए रखने के लिए स्टेट गवर्नमेंट शुरू से ही कह रही थी, तो जब वो लोग संतुष्ट हो गए तो चौथी डेड बॉडी का आज डिस्पोजल हुआ
जी।
और सभी लोग ऐसा लग रहा था जैसे वहां उसी तरफ जा रहे थे, तो कुछ पहले लोगों के मूवमेंट को रिस्ट्रिक्ट किया गया, आज से उनको प्रत्येक लोगों की 5-5 टोली परमिट की गई, और कल ही शाम को
जी।
हम लोगों ने एक कमेटी बना दी है जो कि इस पूरे इन्वेस्टिगेशन को देखेगी और हर एक एस्पेक्ट को देखेगी, इसमें जितने भी वीडियोस आए हैं या और भी जो टेक्निकल एस्पेक्ट्स हैं उनको अध्ययन करके जो साक्ष्य संकलन करेगी, उसके बाद से इसमें आगे की कार्रवाई की जाएगी। हम लोगों ने एक टोल फ्री नंबर भी दिया है और हमने एक ईमेल आईडी भी दिया है। बहुत सारे ऐसे वीडियो भी जो हैं जो इस इंसिडेंट से रिलेटेड नहीं है, लोग भ्रामक सूचनाएं फैला रहे हैं ताकि शांति व्यवस्था की स्थिति उत्पन्न हो जाए, तनाव की स्थिति हो जाए, वर्गीय संघर्ष हो जाए, तो इन सब चीजों को देखते हुए आगे की कार्रवाई की जा रही है।
नहीं, मेरा मेरा बड़ा सिंपल सा सवाल है कि जो आपने इतनी चीजें बता दी कि कमिटी बनाई गई, एक टीम बनाई गई, एक नंबर दी गई, अगेन मैं बात आपसे सामने रखता हूं कि एट द एंड ऑफ द डे ये क्लियर कट केस ऑफ मर्डर है। 8 लोग मर चुके हैं, कुछ कुछ डेथ्स वीडियो पे कैप्चर भी हुई हैं। तो ऐसे केस में पिछले कोई भी आप एग्जांपल देख लीजिए, यूपी पुलिस ने कम से कम, मतलब इससे भी कम जो ऑफेंसेस हैं, इमीडिएट अरेस्ट आपने किए हैं। तो इसी केस में क्यों है कि डिले किया जा रहा है? सबका यही एक आशंका है क्योंकि इसमें वीआईपीज इन्वॉल्व हैं, मंत्री जी हैं, वो मान रहे हैं कि हमारी थार की गाड़ी है जो वीडियो में दिख रही है, जो फार्मर्स को कुचल रही है, उनके बेटे का नाम आया है। क्या ये वीआईपी फैक्टर की वजह से यूपी पुलिस रुकी हुई है?
जी 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 नहीं, उत्तर प्रदेश पुलिस को सारे साक्ष्य संकलन के बाद से कोर्ट में जवाबदेही, कोर्ट के प्रति जवाबदेही है, और शुरू में ही स्पष्ट किया जा चुका था कि इसमें कोई भी दोषी नहीं बख्शा जाएगा।
तो
कोई भी विवेचना होती है तो स्टूडियो में बैठकर या हमारे ऑफिस से बैठ के चीजें नहीं तय की जाएंगी, जो विवेचक साक्ष्य संकलन करेगा। अभी तक एक बहुत बड़ी चुनौती थी कानून व्यवस्था बनाए रखने की, जो कि आज सुबह जाके सभी चीजें, बॉडी, लास्ट बॉडी आज क्रिमेट हुई है और बहुत तेजी से हम लोग विवेचना कर रहे हैं, और जो गिरफ्तारी इत्यादि की चीजें हैं बहुत जल्द ही हम लोग करेंगे और आप लोगों को अवगत भी कराएंगे।
जी, तो क्या अभी तक आपने जो अजय मिश्रा हैं जिन्होंने माना है कि उन्हीं की गाड़ी है, या आशीष मिश्रा उनके बेटे हैं, क्या अभी तक आपने उनकी कोई पूछताछ की है?
मैंने आपको बताया कि धैर्य रखिए, जिस तरह से हम लोगों ने सभी चीजें सही लाइन से की हैं और पूरे पारदर्शी और शुचिता बनाए रखते हुए किया है, आगे भी हम उस तरह से करेंगे और बहुत जल्द ही इस केस का खुलासा करेंगे।
इसमें प्रशांत कुमार जी, आप ये नहीं मानते कि जितना डिले होता है ऐसे सेंसिटिव केस में, और जो खासकर एक्यूज लोग पावरफुल हैं तो वो विटनेस इन्फ्लुएंस कर सकते हैं, बहुत सारी चीजें कर सकते हैं, इसी वजह से कहा जाता है कि अरेस्ट शुड बी इमीडिएट, इसका कोई रिस्क नहीं है?
नहीं, ऐसा नहीं है, अरेस्ट भी होती है और साक्ष्य संकलन के बाद ही आजकल कुछ ऐसे टेक्निकल साक्ष्य होते हैं, ह्यूमन एविडेंसेस और ह्यूमन विटनेसेस कैन टर्न होस्टाइल बट टेक्निकल एविडेंसेस आर परमानेंट, सो वी विल नेल द कल्प्रिट विद ऑल द माइट ऑफ द लॉ अवेलेबल एट आवर हैंड,
बट यू आर
बॉडी विल बी स्पेयर्ड,
बट यू आर सेइंग दैट दे हैव नॉट इवन बीन क्वेश्चनड, यू हैव नॉट इवन स्टार्टेड क्वेश्चनिंग द मिनिस्टर और हिज सन।
काइंड ऑफ, हमने कहा दिस काइंड ऑफ स्वीपिंग रिमार्क्स इज नॉट प्रॉपर, प्लीज वेट, वी विल डेफिनेटली नेल द ऑल द एक्यूज्ड हु आर इन्वॉल्वड इन दिस इंसिडेंट।
सो इज देयर नो प्रेशर ऑन यू ऑफ एनी काइंड?
व्हाट काइंड ऑफ प्रेशर इज देयर? वी हैव इट, वी हैव बीन
गो स्लो और टू नॉट एक्ट अगेंस्ट देम
बाय द हाईएस्ट एग्जीक्यूटिव ऑफ द स्टेट बाय ट्वीटिंग दैट नोबडी विल बी स्पेयर्ड, इट इज इन पब्लिक डोमेन।
ओके,
then FIR has been registered, the family is satisfied, the courts, we will convince the court also, and definitely we will, wherever it is necessary and whenever it is necessary, we will brief the press and media will be briefed at regular interval, we will take all stakeholders on board.
So the question that's being asked, sir, is that while when it comes to the arrest in the case of the murders of those people, you feel that you have to proceed with great caution and slowly. But when it came to arresting opposition leaders like Priyanka Gandhi, who were on the way there, that was done immediately.
No. That I have already clarified that everybody has been stopped in the larger public interest, keeping law and order into consideration. Suppose somebody is visiting, something happens to the VIP. Then again, you will blame the state government and the state police. Now the things are normal. Everybody has been permitted. In a small numbers.
But what was the earlier apprehension?
These law and order things and priorities are being decided by the local administration, and they have requested, they have sent a written request that such and such nobody should be allowed to enter Khiri or Bahraich.
No, but Prashant Kumar ji, that would have been a valid argument if you had blocked everybody. But the argument is that it was selective. The argument is it was selective that a leader like Rakesh Tikait was allowed to come, others were not allowed. Only Rakesh Tikait was allowed to come, and with him a settlement was reached with all the parties.
Not from any political party, he is a Kisan leader, and Kisans have died. That's why he reached there immediately, and then he was the person. The everybody present there accepted Mr. Tikait and authorized him to negotiate. And apart from the Panth leader, we are sitting there. I think when the settlement was announced, so many people were sitting there, and you can verify that other Panth leaders were also there, and no political party. They themselves were not permitting any political person to reach there.
For their safety,
we didn't allow anybody.
But legally, sir, because you are operating, of course, under the ambit of the law, as all of us are, legally, how would you justify allowing party A and party B? Because the law doesn't selectively say that you can allow politicians or not allow politicians and allow X and Y leader. Right?
No.
There's no legal provision which distinguishes.
We never allowed any political person to go there. There are certain honorable MPs who tried to reach there, and they were also stopped at the from reaching their spot.
Mm.
And our endeavor was just to not do anything which can disturb the communal harmony or the social harmony there, and keeping the security of the VVIP visiting that place also, because the things were very volatile. I had personally gone and visited the spot.
No. So when you talk of the settlement, I think that is something which is again a point which people are questioning, that settlement hota hai kisi panchayati settlement ki koi dispute ho gaya.
This is a murder case.
People have been killed.
No settlement. Compensation was announced, and we agreed for the judicial commission, and we agreed for an impartial investigation, and all the the compensatory things which were given to the victim family. There was no other settlement. It was announced in public.
I know, sir, but I'm saying because of the delay in arrest, we've seen the minister, Mr. Ajay Mishra, he came today to Delhi, he met the Home Minister, some conversation took place on whether he should continue or not. He's moving around freely. Again, I put to you,
How will people believe this is fair enforcement
of law when the father of a murder accused, being a minister, is roaming everywhere, meeting senior public functionaries in Delhi, his son is still at large. Surely you see why people would have doubts in their mind.
No. You see, it is how you look at things. Whether a glass is half empty or it's half full, it is up to the person who is looking at things.
But I am assuring you,
time and again reiterated in public domain that nobody will be spared.
Okay.
And the time will tell how we will act. And nobody will be spared. We'll definitely nail the culprit. We'll book them. We'll produce them in the court of law. And then we'll charge it.
Is it possible to share with us, because as I mentioned, now we are on the fourth day, is there any indication you have No, no, let me just ask the question. Is there any indication you have which does point towards the involvement of Ashish Mishra or his father in the violence, in the killing?
In law and order and criminal investigation, you cannot set deadline, fixed deadline.
Okay.
But we are in, we are also aware that the whole world is looking at us and our accountability is there for everyone. So we would also not like that the public...
If you're saying you're acting without fear or favor, how do you explain the fact that... How do you explain the fact that about several days before this incident, the minister made a very provocative speech where he said, "Hum kisanon ko 2 minute mein theek kar denge agar hume chance mile." Why was no action taken against him for a speech like that?
You see, there are so many videos which are floating. I have already told that whether those videos are correct or not, everything will be taken into account.
But sir, that speech is in the public domain.
No, you see, public, nobody is going to give testimony in the court of law if something goes wrong. So whatever is there, we will get it verified and then we'll proceed.
Including, if it comes to that, including the provocative speech made by the minister, that will also be investigated?
We have already given a number and an email ID that we'll keep the name secret of any the person giving the information, and we will keep everything into consideration to meet the end of the justice.
So at the moment, sir, you're saying there is no restriction on anybody traveling to Lakhimpur Khedi if they're moving in small groups. There is free movement now. Political leaders can go.
We have the local administration has conveyed that the 144 is there, and fortunately everybody is complying with the order.
Okay.
All the political party, we are allowing 5 people. If they want, they can go and see the area and come.
So last question, sir, then by when do you think there will actually be action? By when will the first arrest start happening as per you?
No, we have succeeded in controlling the law and order situation. We are already proceeding with the investigation, and we'll arrest few people, and then we'll let it get published in the...
So Rakesh Tiket has said apparently a 5-day deadline has been given.
You see, I have already told you that we are also aware of our responsibility and accountability. Mm. And today morning itself, we are slightly free from the law and order angle. And now we will definitely take action.
Okay.
And our investigation will proceed at a very... in a speedy manner.
All right. Prashant Kumarji, thank you very much indeed for taking
time
out to talk to NDTV. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
All right. Let me go straight across to a senior Congress leader, leading lawyer, MP Kapil Sibal has been patiently listening in. Thank you so much, Mr. Sibal, for listening in. Straight away to ask you, what did you make of this top cop saying that, look, first we had to sort out the law and order issues, that's why the arrests have got delayed, but we will make sure the arrests happen?
I'm just shocked at what he said. I mean, I just didn't understand when he made that statement that the glass can be half empty and half full, depending on how you look. I just don't understand. He's a witness, he's an ideal witness who never answers any question. I mean, I have experienced witnesses who we have asked questions, and they are masters at prevaricating, masters not answering. So I think I must give Prashant Kumar full marks for answering nothing. But I think the most important thing here is to understand that it is the admitted position that the Jeep belonged to the minister.
Yes.
That's admitted?
Yes, the minister has admitted
that. If that's admitted, that all that had to be done is to find out who was driving the Jeep.
Hmm.
Right. So if you find out who was driving the Jeep, you'd know who was sitting in the Jeep.
Yes.
Right? And And you would then interrogate the driver to find out that why he did this. Now, that's easy. So first of all, the fact that it was the minister's jeep, he cannot be in office even for a single minute.
Right.
Because it is because of his jeep that this happened. And lives were lost.
Mm.
Total of 8 lives were lost. So the minister can't continue to be in office.
Not only is he in office, he was in Delhi today meeting the Home Minister.
Yes, therefore I said it's the Prime Minister who must answer that as to why he has not ensured the dismissal of the minister whose jeep it was which led to the death of so many Kisans and other people. Point number one. Point number two, that we are now seeing the experiment in Jammu Kashmir succeeding in Lucknow. If you remember, this is exactly what happened in Jammu Kashmir. People wanted to go into Jammu Kashmir. They were stopped at the airport. Mm. They were not allowed to enter. Many political functionaries were not allowed to enter. Some of them who were allowed to enter were allowed to enter under strict conditions. Right? That experiment succeeded in Jammu Kashmir. Now, that same experiment is being now tried out in Lucknow.
Mm.
What business does heavy administration have to say that you will be detained at the airport or you will not be allowed to enter Lucknow? Under what law? This is this same police. This is the same police who is doing this.
Right.
What is the justification for this?
No.
I can understand if the imposition of 144. There's no imposition of 144 at the airport or in Lucknow.
Right.
And even if there is, how can you stop anybody entering Lucknow?
Just coming back for a second to the actual murder itself, because there are reports that the driver was of that jeep was one of those who was actually killed, but there are eyewitnesses who say they saw the minister's son. Now, this is something which other legal experts have also weighed in. So I wanted to get your view that in a murder case, how imperative is it that the arrest is almost immediate? Because the answer from the police seems to be we will do jaanch, we will set up committees, etc., etc.
Timing is of the essence in a murder case. Right? Now, from what I hear Prashant Kumar saying, he's telling you that, look, I wanted to control law and order first.
Yes.
And now I will start the investigation.
Yes.
By which time you will realize that the administration will make sure that evidence is cooked up or manipulated in a sense to save the minister's son and to save the minister. That is precisely why in a police investigation in the case of a murder or any serious crime, the investigation must be immediate.
Right.
If the driver is dead, then those who are in the car should immediately have been arrested because they were in the car when this happened.
And
the moment they are arrested, you would get the true story. And then if there's an FIR and the son is named in the FIR, the son must be arrested. Now, what is happening is that the minister is making a statement that the son was at the place where the gathering was held, where the function was to take place.
Hmm.
Now, there's another statement where the minister is saying, no, there was a family function and he had to be there.
Right.
Now, all this is being done to ensure that the son is saved. And I don't understand with what sort of logic. Mr. Prashant Kumar can say to you that we are worried more about the law and order situation than we are worried about who killed so many people.
Last question, we're very short on time. Are you hopeful that because of the public noise and the political noise, there will be some attempt at justice, or you're not hopeful?
You've seen the track record of the Uttar Pradesh government. In fact, ultimately what happens is that other people become accused and the person who has actually committed the crime, he is shown to have been actually the victim.
Right.
So I'm afraid that the story of this investigation is going to go along the same way.
Okay.
That ultimately others will be accused and the gentleman will say that I was never there. And people's statements would be recorded that they saw him here, they saw him here, they saw him there. He was never there.
Right.
And these people. And the other thing, I think, before you finish this program, this is something very shocking. This is a private matter, no?
Hmm.
It's a private matter between a person whose convoy it was, which resulted in the death of so many people.
Yes.
Right? Now, 45 lakhs, I'm very happy that they've got that compensation, but I want to know, 45 lakhs is being given by the state to private individuals in the context of a private dispute.
Right.
This was not yeah. because of any functioning of government or anything like that that resulted in the death of so many people. This was not some flood that took place or some natural event or something like that. It was a private dispute.
Okay, that's an interesting... We're completely out of time. We'll have you back soon on this. But that's an interesting point. And I was trying to ask him that as well, about the idea that this is some kind of settlement that has arrived between parties.
How can the state, settle by saying, I'll give 45 lakhs?
Yeah, this is not a...
On whose behalf are they doing it?
Yeah.
On whose behalf is 45 lakhs being given?
Yeah, so many, many questions there. Kapil Sibal, we'll have you back. We're out of time, but we will track this story. Thank you for watching Reality Check. Good night.